intense to watch. So
it was interesting how often Elegant had to call out what Abba was going to do after getting hit, like, or in neutral in general. Like, I remember in game one, or game two specifically, he called out his full hop the minute it happened, the instant it happened. But back air. But he didn't kill him, but, like, it was a got him off stage.
Right.
So getting into
Void,
this match, Sparg0 versus Void.
Pichu versus Cloud, what's your take on that one?
It's going to be pretty annoying for Cloud, mainly because Pichu's tiny and can gimp him really easily. But it's not terrible by any means. Cloud can hold his own versus pretty much every character in this game. Like, he's solid enough to be able to do so.
And this is Sparg0 too.
Yeah, Sparg0 did prove his mettle. Like, he upset Zenyu earlier, and that was very impressive.
Very impressive,
set. Yeah.
And here comes the fair chain. Hits two of them. Not unable to get the third one.
All right, I like how he didn't immediately go for the neutral ghetto punish there, just in case, like, because you can get reversal there if you miss. So he just went for the, okay, I'm going to read what he does afterwards, before he just stayed in shield.
Yep, and we're seeing immediately Void playing passive, knowing that Sparg0 has limit.
Yeah.
Smart choice.
You have to be very careful.
Go wrong with that. And that shield looking like an M&M. No, up B
and punish.
Shield.
Good punish. His up B is one of the best out of shield options.
And the up smash to take the stock, so Sparg0 already had a really good lead.
Oh, didn't get the game bear. There's a really good ledge snap by Sparg0. Good landing catch by Void.
Oh.
Caught the air.
So catching out the air dodge, the up air. Although they're not as good as Smash 4, it is still disjointed.
Yes, it's still very good for catching landings. Juggling people in the air. Not so much catching landings. More catching, like, drifting downwards.
Uh-huh. In the back. Oh, he tried
to that's
use
unfortunate. That limit timer.
I don't think it would have hit, though, unfortunately.
Either way, it would have been more, because it would have moved quicker than that.
That's true.
It would have been much better, but he did lose his limit.
Trying to use the F tilt. Pichu's F
tilt. That's down tilt, actually.
F tilt?
That's down tilt,
okay.
Yeah.
But takes the stock already, but remember, Void is at 80% as Pichu. That's already kill percent.
Pretty much, yeah.
For a glass cannon like him.
He can die to pretty much any of his. Like, right now at the ledge, this is very scary.
Yeah.
And I realize Sparg0 is amazing at the ledge.
Uh-huh.
He just sets up a wall. That, like, it tempts you to roll, too, but he covers it. He covered it very well versus the set with Zenyu earlier, and right now, set up the same thing at the ledge.
And, oh, that back air barely missed.
Dude, Void spent most of this game at the ledge.
Yeah.
Like, or not center stage.
It just shows how dominant Sparg0 can be on this
club. Cornered or at the ledge has been this entire game, pretty much.
And what was really cool to watch about, oh,
wow,
yeah,
reversal
couldn't
there.
Get the combo. So, what I loved watching about Sparg0 and Zenyu is that Sparg0 has so much ledge pressure.
That was such a good, jab block? Is he going to die?
Oh, no! Was that a mix-up attempt?
I don't know. I feel like he... I thought he was going to go for something like down tilt bear.
I thought it was down tilt dare.
Down tilt dare as well, yeah. But he just went for the F smash, I guess. I mean, it looked like it could have comboed. Like, it was possible.
So, also, one more thing. Like I was saying, so Sparg0 versus Zenyu, one of the best parts about watching that is that Sparg0 has so much ledge pressure. But Zenyu is so patient, even at the corner. So it was just a big chess match that was happening for both of them. Because a lot of amateur players, and even top level players at sometimes, they feel so pressured when they're at the edge like this.
They immediately
try to get out, just like with Void did.
Wow.
And the up smash to catch it out, Sparg0 with
goodness.
The two stock. There we go, Sparg0 is turning up the heat.
Insane, dude.
If you're Void right now, I wouldn't be surprised if you switch.
Yeah, I think so too. Or it just, goes in with Pichu with a different game plan.
Yeah. Different game plan, different stage.
Because Pichu can definitely just wash Cloud. Like,
it's true.
It can just happen.
It's also true, but the problem is that Pichu got hit hard with those patches. The patch that just came.
I mean, he got hit
pretty hard.
Yes, this is true, but...
But he still got the same neutral game. But
it's the same character.
Yeah, it's still the same character. And, you know, Void didn't rely on side tilt to kill.
Yeah.
It was just
It's not that good of a kill move anymore. It doesn't kill at like 90, 100, 110. It kills at 150 now, 140, 150, 160.
It was
at the ledge, too. It doesn't kill center stage. Like, it's
good anymore.
It's good. It's just not ridiculous. Like, it's fine. It's not super broken. It's not. It's fine. It reminds me of Wolf's F tilt in the sense that not range or disjointedness wise, just the way it's used, where it's used, at what percent it's used.
That's true. And also,
counterpicking to Yoshi's punishes. Okay. Ooh, I thought he'd do upper out of shield because turning around and grabbing that is a stretch because
he's trying to get the loop set up.
Uppy has so little lag that it's really hard to punish with anything that isn't a jumping immediate aerial out of shield, or if he's in you, just shield grab him if you have the range for it.
So. It's also not just that, you know, Pichu's bad. It just shows how good Sparg0's playing.
No, Sparg0's playing amazing. I don't think the patch is what's deciding this at all. I think it's a small hindrance to Void's play right now. And not even. Like, I think he's already gotten used to it, all this stuff, and he's playing Pichu for a reason, right? Like,
Yeah, and VoiD's seated
number
one. Yeah,
wow.
VoiD is doing so well. He's catching on every. He's turning up now. I think he's really used game one to kind of center himself and saying, I made this mistake. I need to do this against Sparg0. And here we go.
Down tilt. Oh, down air, my bad.
Yeah, that was a great wall jump by Sparg0 to mix up the recovery time. Up throw into Thunder.
Up throw. Okay, he gets off the Thunder, but it doesn't quite get the positioning for it. But he was able to react to the DI.
Uh-huh. And once again, Thunder once more. Lightning does strike twice, apparently.
Except one time it misses, and the second time it just hits.
It struck, okay, buddy. All right, so VoiD, here comes the combos that we're talking about.
Nice. I thought he'd do the drag down back air into another follow-up, but I feel like he either messed it up or didn't want to go for it.
He missed up the first time. I think he just wanted to get the damage down and be done with it. So 43%, 58. Here it comes, the dare. That's not enough. Great tech by Sparg0, and uses the get-up tech as well.
Massive get-up attack. that thing's range is huge.
But here we go. Needs to get
all right,
ledge.
He might die here.
Oh, he's fine, and the up tilt, the down tilt.
DI'd in tech thanks to the slant on Yoshi.
And
will this kill?
It? No, that's not enough. But Sparg0 has to jump using it.
Oh my goodness,
oh my
Sparg0.
God. Oh, that was kind of huge.
The thief kinda in the huge. Night.
Now, Sparg0 is in a tough position still, but this is like...
That's a huge game breaker.
This could just happen. It could just snap of the fingers.
40%, here we go, back air.
Dude, Sparg0 is going in, dude.
He misses the back
caught his jump. This is a horrifying position to be in.
Another one.
Doesn't have a jump.
He's gonna.
Oh!
He's
that's
got it.
That's
he's
it.
He's got it. Sparg0, two upsets in
oh
a row.
Goodness.
Are you joking?
Two. We just said two like eight times, but who cares?
Wow.
Sparg0 taking it over VoiD with a crazy comeback game two. Excuse me. Now that up B spike, kind of unfortunate for VoiD.
But still,
I'm very surprised it killed him. But thinking about it, strong spike, Pichu's light, so he's just gonna die. Like,
remember, it Smash Ultimate. It's just.
It is, yeah. It's one of the weakest up B spikes relative.
The problem is that Smash Ultimate, one mistake can cost you an entire game. That was, and that's exactly.
Especially
what
Especially his Pichu, right? Like, he's light, he's small, so he's not like easy to hit. But Sparg0, like, called out every single one of his options
and
got him to like 50, 60, 70 and side beat him at the limit.